You know, there's one more thing I want to point out on Project Elsie that really made a big difference, and that's Man-A-Fre's U-Bolt Reversal Kit. Now, whether you just go with the old man EMU suspension system, or you take it to the next step and put Man-A-Fre's shackle reversal system on it, I highly recommend you use the U-Bolt Reversal Kit. Now, what this does on the Toyotas, you've got the U-Bolts that hang down. And so that they hang down, even if you trim them off, you still got the nuts and some of the threads hanging down underneath the leaf springs and the axles, which just, it's begging to just auger into any rock or mound that you go over. The Man-A-Fre kit actually turns those U-bolts around, puts them to the top, and it makes a real nice smooth surface on the bottom for just sliding over the rocks and the bumps. So whichever way you go, I recommend you use the Man-A-Fre U-bolt reversal kit just because it's a lot smoother on the bottom. Now, speaking of serious, if you're going to go four-wheeling and do anything other than just say the typical, I'm going to go down this fire road and explore, I'm not talking even the hardcore guys, even medium trail riding, one of the best things that you could put on your four-wheel drive is a high lift jack. Now, for those of you that are, say, my age or around there, this may look an awful lot like the typical old bumper jack, which in basically that's what it is. It's just a well-built, well-designed bumper jack, and it does several things. Because it's a high lift, you can get underneath here and lift your vehicle from your rocker guards, which in our case we don't have rocker guards yet, but we'll do. You can hook it onto your bumper and lift from your bumper. You can get a lot more lift than you can off of a bottle jack, but it's also got other functions as well. You can turn this top and actually use it to clamp pieces together. If you're welding, I've heard stories of people actually clamping suspension A-arms together on the front and driving out with a high lift jack stuck through their hood while they're getting their vehicle down someplace where they can get it repaired. For those of you without winches, you can also even use this as a winch device to get you moving by fastening this part to the immovable obstacle and the other part to the vehicle and jacking it and getting it closer together. Works just like a winch. Another really good thing, especially for people in the desert, is to make sure you get the high flotation base. Because if you're in the sand and you're wanting to get this up out, it's really good to have the good high flotation bottom on this to keep the jack from falling down into the sand and actually jacking the jack down rather than the vehicle up. So, you know, it would be one of those really valuable tools to put on your four-wheeler. We did on our Project Land Cruiser. Now, any project, whether it's a 4Runner or FJ40 or a Jeep or R60, can benefit by one of these products. And it's a Tuffy box. Now, one of the best things about a Tuffy box is that it gets rid of the stock console. And on anything, even something that I consider as quality as a Toyota Land Cruiser, cheap plastic. So while the Tuffy box is really designed for open vehicles like TJs, YJs, CJs, because now you can lock up some valuables, leave your vehicle open. They also make boxes for the back ends of them, but this one specifically for the Land Cruiser that we got is an 8-inch wide. It even has the lockable place for your stereo. Again, real valuable for TJs and YJs where they're out in the open. You can put your stereo in there, lock it up when you get out of the car. Comes with, you know, places to hold items, has a cup holder on the front. You can get another optional cup holder for the back just as well. Really a cool product, no matter what, it's quality and security. So hey, that's our show for this week. Till next time, go four-wheeling and God bless.